Hello there, everybody. So, Butter Knight, Wicked Hammer, and welcome back to Fate Stay Night Unlimited Blade Works. Now, in the last episode, I coughed quite frequently, and I attempted to clear my throat. So, in preparation for that, I basically spent the first 10 minutes before I even started recording hacking up my lungs and tearing away my throat. So, I deeply apologize for that. As I stated, I was still kind of getting over a cold. I still partially am, but I should be feeling quite a lot better now. So thankfully, there should be no issues this time. Again, I will deeply apologize for, yesterday's piss-poor episode. Anyway, let's jump right back in to Fate Stay Night. Bonnie and Clyde. This is the thing that's been bothering, been making me worry. I wonder what it's trying to go with here. This is a story from a winter 5 years ago. It was a night with a beautiful moon. I wasn't doing anything, just watching the moon with Kiritsugu. Even though it was winter, the air wasn't cold. The corridor was a little chilly, but it was a good night to enjoy the moon. Back then, Kiritsugu didn't leave the house often. Wait, have we ever seen this? Not going outside, he would just laze around the house carelessly. I regret it even now, thinking back to it. Why didn't I notice that it was like the actions of an animal that knows its time of death? Yeah, I think we've seen this. Suddenly, that man, himself a superhero in my child's eyes, said that as if yearning for it. Okay, let's see. Let's see. Okay, so something must be different this time. I became angry and asked him. Kiritsugu laughed apologetically and looked up at the sky. I agreed with that. I didn't know why, but I thought it couldn't be wrong because Kiritsugu said so. Kiritsugu answers. So of course, my response was determined. Before I could finish, my father laughed. He made a face like he didn't even need to hear the rest. After breathing in, Emiya Kiritsugu said,
Ah. 安心した.
He quietly closed his eyes, and his life ended. That is the story from a winter 5 years ago. It was a parting that determined the course of Emiya Shiro's life. It was the night that Emiya Shiro decided to become a superhero. There's no way I can forget it. I never said it, but I clearly remember it. The figure of the man who saved the boy who was left to the fire. Emiya Kiritsugu held up the dying child and said, "Thank you." He said, "I'm thankful that I found you." He made a big smile and thanked someone as if he was saved by rescuing someone. The emotion I felt back then is still engraved in my mind. Nobody saved me. I couldn't save anybody. In it all, I was saved, and a person was there to save me. That's why I decided to become like him. Become a superhero so that I could save people and let no one be killed, just like him. Even if it may be a childlike fantasy, I yearned to become one. And thus, Kiritsugu, the embodiment of my dream, died peacefully, leaving me his dream of becoming a superhero himself. It's only natural for a child to succeed his father. Emiya Shiro must become a superhero and save everyone, just like the old me. I swore so as a child, to fulfill the dream of the man I admired most. But, to be honest, I'm still wondering if my idea is the right one. Where my idea comes from. what I can do even despite me being just an amateur. How to make the dream of making everybody happy, which Kiritsugu always talked about, come true. And what I can do now that I'm a master. There are just so many things that my head's going to explode. I wake up from that familiar dream. Bright morning sunlight is coming in from the window. I feel a bit chilly, but I guess it wasn't bad enough for me to catch cold.
Maitta. Mata koko de nemutte shimatta no ka.
I shake my head and change into my uniform. It's a bit before 6 o'clock. I bet Sakura's already up and preparing breakfast. Yeah, I hope the girls slept fine. I go outside and breathe in the fresh air. It's a nice morning. It'd be much more comfortable if there weren't three girls in the house.
Ah, 訂正. 女の子は二人だけだった.
I don't want to class Fujine as a girl. Anyway, now... Yet another choice we have been brought. What should I do? Well, personally, I do want to help Sakura because, honestly, I find Sakura to be likable. But I feel like she's just, you know, getting the cold shoulder. So, let's do this. I'll go help Sakura out. She's making breakfast for four people. I bet it'll be more time-consuming. And I also want to hear what happened last night. It seems Saber went with my story, but there's a possibility that they started disliking each other after a night together. I hope not. Is that a typo? I've already starting to prepare breakfast. I think you meant to say I'm already starting to prepare breakfast.
Ah, ohayo, Sakura. 朝の支度なら俺も手伝うから、ちょっと席開けてくれ.
I go into the kitchen after putting my apron on.
じゃあ焼き物をお願いしますね. さっきご飯は炊きましたから、私はお味噌汁とお惣菜をやっつけちゃいます.
Sakura efficiently keeps cooking like always. She doesn't seem to be worried about yesterday.
Sakura, その 昨日の話なんだが。
はい。 昨日の話って どの話でしょう、先輩?
いや、だから昨日の話。 サクラとフジネとセイバー 3人で寝ただろ? サクラ、 セイバーが住むことを気にしてたみたいだから どうなのかなって。
どうなのかな?じゃ分かりませんよ、先輩。 もっとはっきり言ってくれないと。
Okay.
だから仲良くやってくれると嬉しいんだが。ああ、セイバーさんと私が仲良くすると先輩は嬉しいんですか?嬉しいっていうか助かる。セイバーの住み込みはさくらに無断で決めちまっただろ?だからさくらが怒るのは当然で。
セイバーを嫌うのも仕方がないことだ。けど、そのあたりを多めに見てくれて、セイバーに優しくしてもらえると、なんていうか。セイバーさんにじゃなくて、私に嬉しい。It's embarrassing to say it, so I just nod. She's right. I'd be happy for Sakura if she would forgive me for letting Saber stay. Since Sakura is like a family member to me, it'll relieve me if she can forgive my selfish decision. Starting midnight. Sakura's smile comes from the bottom of her heart. That makes me really happy. It is, but...
Kawaii... Saber ga?
So desu yo. Fujimura-sensei nante Saber-chan te yondemasu shi. Saber-san mo narete kureta mitai desu.
Hmm.
Honto ba, kanshi suru tame no doushitsu dattan desu kedo, 今夜も3人で寝ようってことになっちゃいました。
That's an unexpected turn of events. But Saber's cute, huh? She's beautiful, but I don't know about being cute. Everyone says itadakimasu. Did I pronounce that right? I probably didn't. This is the first time I've had breakfast in a group of four, and it feels rather relaxing.
これ微妙に薄味だな。だし変えたのか、さくら。
はい、セーバーさん、お味噌汁に慣れてないと思って。あんまりお味噌が濃いのもダメかなって。
そうですね。昨夜の味付けより今朝の方が美味しいと思う。ですが、さくら、私も和風の食事には慣れていますから、そう気を使わず自由に調理してください。その方がお互いのためになる。
え、そうなんですか？わあ、ちゃんとお箸持ててる。びっくりしました。セーバーさんって器用なんですね。
I think I've only had miso soup once. It's not that bad. If memory serves.
慣れていますから。ですが、正直に言うと箸は疲れます。フォークやナイフより優れた道具だとは思うのですが。
そうだね。セーバーちゃんはお箸よりナイフとフォークだよね。で、それ違う違う。かけるのはソースじゃなくて醤油。
なるほど。忠告感謝します。
よしよし、報酬として海苔を1枚いただきましょう。はい、白おかわり。
はい、食いすぎて二度寝するなよ。
あの先生、今日の朝練に参加されるなら少し控えた方がいいと思いますけど。
大丈夫大丈夫、これぐらい入れておかないとお昼まで持たないもの。そういうさくらちゃんだって朝練の後におにぎり食べてるじゃない。
ね、
先生知ってたんですか？
No, there's nothing wrong with that.
無振り、端っこでこそこそやってるから気になって観察してたのよ。ダメよ、いい年頃の女の子が朝2食なんて。
You can't blame somebody if they're hungry.
悪魔はこっそりと、ある日テロリストのように体重計に舞い降りるんだから。私の読みではさくらちゃんの今の体重は
ダメダメです先生、言ったらもうご飯作りに来ませんから。
チェ。
それに間食は時々だけです。いつもそんなことしてるわけじゃありません。
あれ、そうなのか。朝飯いつもイチゴ多く炊かれてたから、てっきりさくらが握り飯でも作ってるんだろうなって思ってたんだけど。
先輩も知ってたんですか？
ダメダメ、さくらちゃん、シロね、そういう細かいことには妙に神経質なやつだから、きっと初めておやつを作った時から気づいてたわよ。
初めて？それって去年の夏のこと？
さくら、空中にホコリでもあるのですか？そんなところで手を振って。
Breakfast proceeds like that. The breakfast table is twice as loud as usual.Then suddenly,
今朝未明に発見された被害者は50名を超え、現在は最寄りの救急病院で治療を受けており。
This must be talking about what Tosca and Archer came across. I see some disturbing news on the TV.
シントでまたガス漏れ？うわぁ、今度は50人だって。なになに？被害者には昨夜から連絡が取れず、何人かの家族は不審に思い会社に連絡、警備員に確認させたところ、社内に残っている社員はいなかったとのこと。何これ、 夕方からみんなビルの中で倒れてたのに、どうして警備員が気がつかないかな。職務怠慢とかそういうレベルの話じゃないよね。
I think we've already figured out that it had something to do with Castor, but these guys obviously don't know. Fujine must have lost her appetite as she stops eating her third bowl of rice. Saber's watching the news with intense expression. In that case, I'm not mistaken. I don't know the motive, but this is something that's done by a master. I can say it's fortunate that nobody died, just like all the other gas leak incidents.
もう、物騒だな。
That's an understatement.
シロ、しばらく信徒でアルバイトするのは禁止だからね。貯金ならたくさんあるんだから、こんな時ぐらいゆっくりしなさい。
I'm happy that she's worried about me, but I can't reply to her. I know this is no time to be working, but I'm sure I won't be able to come home as often, now that I'm in a war. Then, if I'm ever late, I'll have to lie to them that I'm working. After finishing the cleanup, I go to the front door. Fujine and Sakura already left for their morning practice. Sakura is following me like she did yesterday, but I can't let her do so today.The weekends are fine, but there's no way I can take her to school on a weekday.
Saber, 言っとくけど、ここまでだぞ。学校に行っている間はここにいてくれ。Saber と一緒に学校に行ったら騒ぎが大きくなるし、何より目立つ。マスターは人目につくのは避けるべきなんだろう。
She must not agree as she protests silently.
だから大丈夫だって。人気があるところでは襲われないんだから。学校は安全だ。それにさ、身を守るだけなら俺一人でもなんとかなる。
I don't know, we're already aware of two masters, Shinji and Tosuka. Well, I mean, We, the viewers, are already aware that Shinji is a master. But... Which actually makes me wonder something.If Tosuka is going to be our enemy in this story, would that give Shiro incentive to team up with Shinji? Saber's brow twitches. She must have some argument about me being able to protect myself.
一つ尋ねますが、それはシロを一人で敵を倒せるという意味ですか?
No.
まさか。昼間なら一人でも危険を回避できるってことだ。
Plus, I myself am already aware that he does have the sheath, so...
人気のないところには近づかないし、日が落ちる前に帰ってくる。それならセイバーも納得がいくだろう。お前だって魔力を温存するために休んでなくちゃいけないんだから、無理してついてくることはない。
わかりました。マスターがそう言うのなら、私は信じざるを得ませんね。
She's seriously worried about me. I feel bad about turning her down.
悪い、セイバー。けど大丈夫だって。それにさ、俺の身に何かあったら、セイバーにも伝わるんだろ?もしそうなったら、駆けつけてくれればいいじゃないか。
いいえ、そうはいかないでしょう。私とシローのつながりは細い。マスターの危機が私に伝わるときは、シローの命そのものが危うくなっているときだ。そうなってから駆けつけても遅すぎる。
Also just had another sudden thought. Tosuka was able to assist us in establishing a connection and giving her more magical energy. How the hell are we gonna pull that off in here? I mean, obviously don't tell me, but I'm just questioning myself. How the hell are we gonna do that?
じゃあ、俺の方からセイバーを呼べばいいのか?
But that would use a command spell.
はい。シローが私を必要だと思えば。それはあなたのサーヴァントである私に伝わります。それでも間に合わないと判断したときは、レイジを使ってください。レイジのバックアップがあるのなら、空間を飛んで、シローの守りとなることができるでしょう。
I don't think I remember this ever being explained. I mean, we saw it in action during the battle with Ryder, though. Jump through space. That's pretty much like sorcery.The right to absolute obedience? The command spell is that powerful?
わかった。できるだけそんな事態にならないように立ち回る。日が落ちるまでには帰ってくるから、セイバーは留守を守っていてくれ。
I wave her goodbye and open the door.
はい。どうか気をつけてください、シロ。あなたの学校は異常です。行動には細心の注意を。特にリンには出会わないように。
Yeah, we already know she's gonna try to kill me.
学校で遠坂が仕掛けてくるっていうのか。まさか、それこそありえないだろう。
I wouldn't say impossible, honestly. She's a true magus. She is bound by the association's rule to avoid involving innocent people, and most of all, she wears the mask of an honor student. I think she'll greet me normally if I do see her. No?
そうだといいのですが、リンは人目を気にして判断を鈍らせるタイプではありません。それに、シロを敵視しているようですから、気をつけるに越したことはないでしょう。
I think the other part of the hostility is because I summoned Saber.
はいはい。取り越し苦労だとは思うけど、気をつける。
So I've technically got the most powerful of servants, but I am the weakest of masters. Actually, technically, I guess Shinji would be considered the weakest, but in terms of knowledge, I'm the weakest, I guess. It's past 7 o'clock. It's later than usual, but I should still make it on time without hurrying.It's 7:40. I go through the gate, and as I make my way to the school building, I feel something strange and stop.
別に何がおかしいってわけじゃないよな。
Oh, I know what it is. It's not like someone's watching me or that something looks different. If anything, if it's that it's not that lively. It feels like the students and even the trees in the buildings are dull in color.
気のせいかな。いろいろあって過敏になってるのかもしれない。
I close my eyes and rotate my shoulders, but the strange feeling doesn't disappear even after that. What was it called? The blood prison? I get up to the third floor and head to my classroom. Then, I run into Tosca.
You.
I know her, so I greet her. But Tosca freezes as if she's seen a ghost.
Tosca? なんだよ。顔になんかついてるのか?
I wipe my cheek with my uniform, but Tosca doesn't even reply. She looks away from me and goes back to her classroom. What was that? I don't think it's like her to ignore someone who greeted her. Shiro, Shiro. The strange feeling hits me again when I go to my classroom. Someone might have brought snacks in here, so I smell a slight sweetness in the air.
It's me.いつも通りの教室だよな。
I head to my seat while greeting the guys. There are about 10 more minutes until homeroom starts. I look around the room and I notice a seat without a bag.
シンジのやつ、欠席か。
Oh boy. Come to think of it, he wasn't at the club yesterday either. Shinji's actually quite punctual and he tries hard to follow the rules. It worries me a bit that a guy like him has been absent for 2 days. It's lunchtime.I usually go to the student council room when I make my own lunch. It's because the guys will take my food and the girls will make fun of me if I eat in the classroom.
なんだ、伊勢。お前、昼は食べないのか?
伊勢、I missed you, dude.
ああ、先ほど済ませた。今はともかく眠くてな。昼休みが終わる前に起こしてくれ。
You okay, bro? 伊勢 then puts his head on the table.
なんだ、徹夜でもしたのか?お山じゃ、11時には絶対就寝じゃなかったっけ?
I freaking can't stay up till 11.
そうなのだが、最近寝つきが良くない。いくら眠っても疲れが取れなくてな。おかげでここ数日は暇さえあれば眠っている。
I do envy people who can stay up past that time, or can actually stay up at that time.
なんだそりゃ。暇さえあれば眠ってるんなら眠気なんてないだろう。
ああ、そうなのだがな。いくら眠っても疲れが取れないゆえ、疲れを取るために眠らざるを得ないのだ。矛盾していると分かってはいるのだが、眠いものは仕方がない。
春にはまだ早いんだけどな、一世。
春眠暁を覚えずか。まことに耳が痛い。
Issei doesn't even try to get up. I guess it can't be helped. It looks serious, so I'll stay here until lunch is over.
あれ? ああ、Issei。誰か来たぞ。
知らん。生徒会は店じまいだと言ってやれ。
いや、そう言ってもいいんだが、やってきたのは、くずき先生っぽいぞ。
うん、それはまずい。
Issei gets up slowly and opens the door.
リュード。今朝の弓道部の件だが。
Hello, creepy looking dude. Kuzuki sensei stops his words after seeing that I'm here. Kuzuki Soichiro is the homeroom teacher of class 2A and also in charge of the student council. He's a very strict teacher and quite blunt.
それじゃあ、うちにも帰ってないんですか?
そのようだ。おそらく刑事事件になるだろう。分かっているだろうが、むやみに話すことは避けるように。
Did somebody vanish?
それは分かっています。ですが、そうなるとマトはどうしたんですか?あいつが昨日会っていたと、弓道部の一年が言っていたじゃないですか。
それに関しても同じだ。マトシンジも無断欠席しており、家も留守だそうだ。妹である麻藤さくらは藤村先生の家に泊まっていたというし、事情は知らされていない。
So, two people are missing? Issei and Kuzuki are talking about disturbing stuff. Summing up what they said, it seems that a student's been missing since last night, and Shinji's the last one to talk to that student.
邪魔をしたな。そういった事情もある。また下校時間が早まるだろう。
Quickly stating his business, Kuzuki leaves the student council room.
まったく。なあ、エミア。お前、シンジを見なかったか?
No, not really.
いや、見てない。今朝は弓道場にも行かなかったし、あいつが休んでることはお前も知ってるだろ?
そうか。それならいいんだが。
Issei's face clouds up. Jeez. It's not something I should rudely butt in on, but it seems this concerns the archery club. I'm sorry for Issei, but I should get some information out of him.
Issei, 昨日から家に帰ってないとか言ってたけど、それって誰なんだ?いや、シンジのやつも捕まらないってのは分かったけど。
Honestly, the only other female I know is Mitsuzure, but...
ん?そうだな。エミアも部外者というわけではないし、知っておいてもいいだろう。昨日の夜の話だ。弓道部の練習に出た娘が帰ってこないという連絡があったら、至急練習に参加した生徒たちに話を聞いたところ、行方不明になった生徒と最後に話していたのはシンジだと分かったのだ。
Talk to Shinji?
ちょっと待った。シンジは昨日の練習にはいなかったぞ。それに、弓道部のみんなとはちゃんと校門で別れたんだが。
ああ、エミアもいたらしいな。話はその後だ。忘れ物をした1年生が戻った時、シンジが道場の前にいたらしい。その時にな、シンジとそいつが口喧嘩をしてたそうなんだ。
I have a bad feeling about this.There's only one student that could have been there.
いいっせ。肝心な話をぼかすな。それで、昨日から行方不明になってる生徒ってのは誰なんだ?
Oh, please, not her.
うん。三つ杉彩子。弓道部の師匠だ。彼女は道場の鍵を職員室に戻した後、弓道場前で見かけられてから一向に行方が知れない。
Crap! Issei averts his gaze. Classes end. I don't know if that incident is the reason, but all clubs are cancelled for today. It seems the library is closed as well, so the students are going home in a hurry. There's an announcement that all students are to go home unless they have some special business. I'm the only one left in room 2C. I bet it's like this in other rooms, so I should hurry or there'll be nobody left in the school building. I should go talk to some people before that. I can't go straight home after I found out Mitsuzure's been missing. She's firm and she's stronger than most guys. It's not a trivial matter that she's missing, and most of all, I can't ignore it as her friend. I apologize to Saber and leave my classroom. I should go talk to people in Mitsuzure's class. Room 2A. And who told you that?
Mitsuzuri nara yasumi da. Kyudo buin nara sore gurai shitte iru daro.
Dakara kesseki da tte. Oni no kakuran sa. Aitsu no muchikoku mukesseki mo koko de owari da yo ne.
That's all I could get from the girls in her class. It seems everyone has been told that Mitsuzure is absent because of illness.
Zamashita na. Ashita Mitsuzuri ga kitara kono koto wa tamattete kure.
I wave goodbye and leave. If there's any place to go now, it'd be the archery range.
Dare mo inai ka. So da yo na. Bukatsu wa yasumi nan da kara.
Doesn't mean we can't find clues. The door to the range is shut tight. It doesn't seem like anyone's inside, so it's meaningless to stay here.
Issei ni kiite miru ka. Are kara nanka wakatta kamoshirenai shi.
It's been 3 hours since lunch. It might be possible that she's already been found and it turned out nothing was wrong at all. Man, I didn't think that the student council would be closed as well. There aren't that many people here now, so it'll be difficult to ask around.
Toriaizu modoro. Mitsuzuri no koto nan da kara, Fujine ga nanka shitteru daro shi.
I get my bag and go out into the hallway. The sky is tinted red. The sun is setting and it should get dark in an hour or so. I get to the stairs. As I start walking down, I hear a sound above my head. I look up. There. Oh! Hey, Tosuka. Tosuka is standing at the top of the stairs.
Tosuka, mada nokotteta no ka?
She doesn't answer. First this morning and then just now? I think her glares are getting worse every time I greet her.
Nandayo. Hanashi ga nai nara iku zo, ore.
I raise my bag to show her that I'm going home now. I don't know why, but Tosuka sighs.
Akireta. Servant o tsurezu ni gakkou ni kuru nante, shouki?
She murmurs without emotion.
Shouki ka tte, sonna no touzen daro? Daitai, Saber wa reitai ka dekinai nda kara, gakkou ni tsurete koreru wake nai janai ka.
Sore nara gakkou nante yasumi nasai. Master ga servant nuki de noko noko aruiteru nante, koroshite kudasai tte itteru youna mono yo. Emiya-kun, jibun ga dore kurai obaka ka wakatteru?
Incredibly stupid by some people's standards, apparently.
Obaka tte, sonna koto aru ka? Tosaka koso baka na koto iu na yo na. Master wa hitome no aru tokoro ja tatakawanai ndaro? Nara nichu, toku ni gakkou nante mondai gai janai ka?
Ja kiku kedo, koko wa hitome no aru tokoro kashira?
Ha?
What's she talking about? I don't even need to check if there are people around.
Are.
Why is this? Conveniently, there is no one here. There's no one in the third floor hallway. I'm sure that's the same for the fourth and the second floor. The red-tinted building is quiet. I bet there are only teachers remaining on the first floor.
ようやくわかったみたいね. Honto, asa wa akireta no o torikoshite atama ni kita wa. あれだけ教えてあげたのに、どうして自分からやられに来るのかって。
Saying so angrily, Tosuka rolls up her sleeve. Okay. A slender white arm. On the feminine arm, something like a glowing tattoo appears. It's not a command spell. Could that be...Even though I don't have one, it must be the proof of a magus, a magic crest.
説明するまでもないわよね。
これが私の家に伝わる魔術の結晶よ。ここに刻まれた魔術なら、私は魔力を通すだけで発動させることができる。
Oh, this just got stressful. Yes. A magic crush is like an attached engine, separate from the magic circuit in a magus. There's no difficult incantation or procedure to follow. It is an ultimate hastening mechanism that runs the car called magic just by turning it on. But the magic crush will not show up unless it is in use. The magic crush is like a separate magic circuit that is formed using the magical energy of the magus.
Archer は帰らせたわ。あなたぐらい、この刻印に刻まれた呪いで十分だもの。
There's no emotion in her voice. That makes me realize that she's serious.
逃げてもいいけど辛いだけよ。どうせ勝つのは私なんだから。
She coldly says so. But my head's spinning. Fight here? Why does it have to be here? Why does it have to be now? And why do I have to fight against Tosca?
待って、トーサカ、お前正気か。ここ学校だぞ。下手に騒げば誰がやってくるか分かったもんじゃ。
その時はその時よ。私ね、目の前のチャンスは逃さない主義なの。エミヤ君には悪いけど、ここで片付けさせてもらうわ。それに、今日みたいにフラフラされてたら、私の神経が持ちそうにないし。
What's sad is that I really don't want to think of you as an enemy.
だから待てって。だいたい俺は遠坂と戦う気なんて。
あなたになくても私にはあるの。いいから覚悟なさい、シロ。
She moves her arm and starts the fight. What sort of magic is it? The instant she points her left hand at me, my vision is filled with light. It's about 4 steps forward to the stairs leading to the second floor. If I'm to retreat back to the hallway, it'll also take me about 4 steps to get to cover. This is no time to think. I... I can risk falling down the stairs, but... No, if I'm in the hallway, she can get to shoot me, so stairs. Tosca's serious. There's no place to run, even if I retreat back to the hallway. I'll jump down the stairs in front of me. I kick the floor with full force. It's about 1.5 meters down. I can easily take this kind of height. A running long jump of 1.5 meters high, 1 meter wide. I land without hurting myself. I have an advantage of 1 floor between us. So now I only have to run down to the first floor and get out of the building. What happened? It came from above. It feels like a giant blob of jelly fell on top of me. I can't move my legs. The weight of the jelly is stopping my feet. I try to shake off the pressure on my back. I feel like throwing up when I move. It's cold. I have goosebumps all over me. My joints are hurting. My muscles are heavy. My organs are half shut down. It's not because of the jelly that I can't move. This is a bad case of the cold. Tosca's magic. The Gondor shot. A magic that'll infect the target with a cold has hit me. As a result, my body is so sick that it can't move on its own.
予想通りね。簡単な逃げ道を用意しておけば、まずそこを通ると思ったわ。
Damn it! I hear Tosca's voice from afar, as if she's contacting me from the moon.
先に謝っておくわ。これからすることは、命を取るのと同じぐらいひどいから。
Her cold finger digs into my neck. When I realize it's Tosca's finger and try to fling it away...
さよなら。あなたは知らなかっただろうけど、私、結構前からあなたのこと知ってたんだ。
My consciousness shuts down as if it's shorted out.
あれ?なんだ?もう朝か。
What just happened? I rouse my sleepy mind to pull myself up. It's past 6 o'clock, I should be preparing breakfast now.
おはようございます、先輩。朝食の支度、もうできてますよ。
What's going on?
あれ。またさくら一人に任せちまった。なんかすごく眠くて起きられなくてさ。
え、ダメです、そんなの。今日の夕飯は私の番なんですから、先輩をおとなしくしててください。
しかしだな、朝も夜もさくらに任せっきりってのは甘えすぎだろう。頼むから今夜は譲ってくれ。寝坊のお前を返上したいんだ。
What just happened?
そうですね。じゃあ私もお手伝いしますから、先輩は早めに帰ってきてください。
すまん、バイト今日は早めに上がる。
What did she do? I head to the table while apologizing to Sakura. Breakfast's already on the table and Fujine runs into the last second like always.
おはよう、みんな今朝も元気だね。で、あれ、シロ、どうしたのこれ。
は？どうしたのって何が。フジネ、家に忘れ物か。
あれ、おかしいな。なんかおかしいと思ったんだけど、おかしいところなんてどこもないや。けど引っかかるな。シロ、あんたなんか忘れ物してない？
ん？はあ？忘れ物、例えばどうなんだよ。
私に聞かないでよ。わからないから聞いてるんじゃない。
Did she fuck with everybody's memories?
ね、さくらちゃんはおかしいって思わない？なんか足りないっていうか、なんか忘れてるっていうか。
私は特に内村先生の気のせいだと思いますよ。何も忘れてませんし、誰も忘れていないでしょう。
まあそっか。思い出せないってことは大したことじゃないってことだし。
Fujine seems satisfied. She sits down and starts eating. This is a normal morning in this household. 30 minutes after Fujine and Sakura leave, I leave the house as well. I walk up the hill. It's past 7:30. The road is filled with students like me. A familiar scene. I breathe in the perfect morning air. Then, I notice that a female student is looking at me. She must have found it awkward that our eyes met as she starts walking on quickly.
なんだ、エミア。今、東坂と睨み合っていたのか。
え？ああ、おはよう、伊勢。て、今のは別に睨み合ってたわけじゃない。ただ、目が合っただけだよ。
そうなのか？ならいいが、くれぐれも東坂に喧嘩など売るなよ。あいつは倍返しが信条だからな。残る1年の学園生活を棒に振ることになる。
I don't know how serious he is as Issei murmurs Buddhist scriptures, but that's a needless worry.
バカ、喧嘩を売るも何も、俺あいつ知らないぞ。
Did she fucked with my memory?
いやまあ、すごい美人だったけど、あんなのうちの学校にいたっけ。
うん、それが正しい対応だ。あれは人の手に余る。関わらぬよう過ごすのが人の道というものよ。いや、一時はどうなるかと思ったが、これにて一件落着。
What? Issei goes up the hill. I watch him go as I stand there. A morning scene with nothing missing. My left hand hurts a bit.
一件落着って、何が起きて何が終わったんだ？
I hear the first bell from the top of the hill. It's 8 o'clock already. As the school gate closes, I feel like I'm locked out from something. Nothing comes to mind. I feel uneasy for some reason. I can't think of where to go or where to return to. It was a bad end! Yes. It is time for Tiger Dojo! Whoa!
はい、みんなおめでとう。東坂さんルート、トゥルーエンディングです。
Really?
シローも普通の生活に戻れたし、まさにこれこそ大団円。
I also feel sick to my stomach to be quite honest.
じゃあみんな、次は藤村先生ルート、虎なんていらねえよ冬でお会いしま。そんなわけないでしょ、バカチ
ー。 Hey, Ilya!
ハートっぽい嘘は禁止。 Q&A コーナーで遭難者を出したらダメなんだから。
す
強くなったな、ブルマ。
ブルマ?
あー、先輩、チーズ、今日も素敵っすね。
いいから説明しろ、ブルマ。
うっす、このバッドエンドに来るルートは2つあるであります。
Why does Tosco look like she should be on an episode of freaking Shin-chan?
一つは単純な選択ミス。安易に前に逃げたら撃ち殺されたってやつですね。で、もう一つが少し厄介で、セイバールートからこっちのルートに入った場合かな。わかりやすく言うと、4日目のルートタイトルがフェイトだったくせに、5日目がアンリミテッドブレードワークスの人は4日目の朝からやり直し。
You need to restart from the morning of the fourth day if the fifth day's title was Unlimited Blade Works, even though the title on the fourth day was Fate. I'm not gonna remember that oddly very specific thing, so I'm literally just gonna take a quick picture of that. There we go. To put it more simply.
裏切り者にしよう。
違うっす先輩、同盟結んでないからこのバットになったんであって、シロは裏切ったわけじゃないです。ああ、言っちゃった。ともかく、今回のバット回避方法は2つ。
Okay, so there are two ways to avoid this bad end.
リンに襲われたら後ろに逃げるか、そもそも逃げる選択肢が出てこなかった人は4日目朝からやり直し。
Well, the choice did appear, so... Okay. Okay, let's try the other option. Jump back to the hallway. I don't look back as I jump. I use the corner of the hallway as a shield and jump sideways with all my might. I slide into the hallway. I hear Tosca...Cluck her tongue as something heavy hits the wall. I get back up and look behind me. The wall. The wall I was standing in front of until now is smoking. And, to be more precise, there are three fist-sized burned marks on the wall. It's a projectile weapon. No, that thing is a curse that'll infect the target with a disease.The Gondir shot Tosca was talking about should be something from the Northern European rune, an indirect curse that worsens the disease of the one being pointed at. Its effect is to worsen someone's illness, so it shouldn't be something with any physical effect. But Tosca's Gondir shot is made with such dense magical energy that it looks like a bullet. The problem is, its power is like that of a bullet as well. Wow, as expected of Tosca. It's such a brutal use of force, making a slow curse into an immediate curse.
Duh!
I hear her running after me. I instantly get myself together. There's no time to think. I have to run for now. The hallway is straight. Tosca's using a projectile weapon, so she'll shoot me in the back if I run down here. Tosca sprints out from the corner. Just before that...I jump into the room beside me, room 2F. She shoots the Gondir shots through the hallway. It seems she shot it right after she ran into the hallway.
冗談!あんなの相手にできるか?何が戦いだ?そもそも戦力が違うぞ、戦力が!
I look around the room in a hurry. Is there any protection? Isn't there a shield, an armor, or a bulletproof vest in here?Her footsteps stop in front of the classroom. I'm sure she saw me run in here. Then she must be wary of my setting up an ambush.
なわけあるか、バカ!
I run. I run from the back of the room to the door in front of the room. In that instant, the Gondir shots are mercilessly shot into the classroom. Jeez, she's shooting them like crazy! The bullets go through the walls, hitting everything in the classroom.It would have gotten me if I hadn't moved. Tosca Rin jumps into the classroom. We're about 4 meters apart, in the front and in the back of the classroom. We glare at each other again. No, there's no time for that! I jump out into the hallway. Running into a room isn't a good option. I'll have to run to the stairs over there. Man, she's really merciless! I just scraped my head. Hey, it scraped my sides as well. Now screw you! The bullets fly through the hallway. Actually, the sounds are like those of real bullets. The sound of firing echoes in the hallway, but I made it. I reached the stairs in the nick of time. I run down the stairs. I've won since I made it this far. I run down the stairs and reach the landing. Tosca shouldn't be able to follow me if I make it to the first floor. I gasp. Tosca took a shortcut by jumping over the railing of the stairs. To put it simply, I have to get past that glaring Tosca to make it down to the first floor. Oh, some veins are showing in Tosca's forehead now. It's scary how used I'm getting to this. The instant I realize it's coming, I jump sideways and hear the bullets hit the wall beside me. I run down the hallway in the other direction. The good news is that I'm down to the second floor. If I'm able to run away and make it down to the first floor, I'm sure Tosca won't... I don't know if it's because she's serious or if she's mad about me running away. Tosca's gonder shots are loud enough that it'll have people calling the cops. Being more powerful means that the bullets are bigger. The curse that was just hot when it scraped me is now burning everything it touches. The gonder shot scrapes my leg. My speed goes down. As soon as I figure out she'll catch up before I make it to the stairs, I jump into the room beside me. I go into the classroom and move to the window side. What should I do? I should be able to jump down from the second floor. If I'm going to get shot at, I might as well try escaping from here. I hear Tosca's voice from the hallway. Something like a thin membrane surrounds the classroom. The instant I notice that the boundary field has soundproof effects, I figure out what Tosca's going to do. I jump to the wall. I feel a strong magic being activated. I crouch down, tip over a desk, and hide behind it. This isn't like the gonder shot she's fired up until now. I close my eyes and place my hand on the desk. She's casting a spell. Even though she has help from the magic crest, Tosca is casting her spell. Will I make it? No, I have to make it. I skip every manufacturing process, the process of making another nerve in my spine, and frantically pour magical energy into the desk. Lights and sounds explode. It's an ordinary day after school. The ordinary classroom turns into a dance floor in an instant. Dancing desks. Comparing the bundle of magical energy into the classroom to a pistol is an understatement. As it's shot without pause over a wide range, it's more like a machine gun. I don't know what kind of a curse is in the magical energy, but it's strong enough to be visible to the human eye. As it has mass, it destroys everything it touches. The desks are running crazy like a person on fire. My eardrums are already screwed up from the sound of the dancing desks and the echoing bullets. This is more like a battlefield than a dance floor. But still, I don't see any cracks in the windows. It must be the boundary field Tosca set up. This room is a closed space now. It seems one can enter this space, but not leave. The bullets fired in here are no exception, as the sounds don't escape this room. Jeez. Tosca's angry, but she's still acting like a magus. I put as much magical energy as I can produce into the desk as used as a shield. The only magic I can use is the strengthening magic. I strengthen the desk to defend myself against this rain of magical energy. But it's only for a brief moment. My strengthening magic will only endure this barrage of bullets for about 3 seconds. As a result, I have to redo the strengthening magic right when it wears off and repeat this process. The rain does not stop. Maybe Tosca knows what's going on in this classroom. She might still be attacking because she knows I'm blocking her attacks like this. Then this rain would stop when... I slump my shoulders while concentrating on the desk. Well, let's compare our endurance. Let's have a match to see who will give up first. The match is decided in a flash. It feels like I've gotten knocked out 15 seconds into the first round. I'm not wounded, but I have lots of stamina left, but I can't do anything if my magical energy runs out. I look out from behind the desk. I can't see the classroom too well because of the smoke. I hear a sound. My hand bumps into something on the floor. Well, I guess it could be used as a weapon. I pick up the stick and put my remaining magical energy into it. I swing the stick I strengthened. Well, it won't do me any good to just stand here. I'll be dead if she attacks me again. Maybe I use too much magical energy as I can't even stand up. And the smoke isn't letting me breathe. Tosca's experienced in fighting. She'll just corner me if I stay here. I know she's waiting for me in the hallway, but I can't escape out the window because of the boundary field. I make up my mind and head to the hallway. My feet are still numb. I move the wreckage of desks and crawl into the smoke before me. And on the other side is... Tosca is waiting for me, her shoulders heaving. I glare at her and manage to stand up. The numbness in my feet is temporary, so I think I can move them if I wanted to. But it's not like running would do me any good. Tosca is just tired from running and she has plenty of magical energy left. Unlike myself, whose magical energy is depleted, Tosca is just out of physical energy. If we resume our battle, I'm sure she'll shoot me down without hesitation. Tosca declares her victory. Oh, that pisses me off. I know it's reckless, but I can't help it if it makes me mad. I raise the leg of the chair to show that I'm resisting to the very end. She smiles. I wish she wouldn't make an ominous smile like that.
ええ、私が謝るのはこれからのことよ、エミヤ君。だって下手に抵抗されたら手加減はできなくなるでしょ。手元が狂ってあなたを殺しちゃったらもう謝罪はできないじゃない。
I liked you better when we had an alliance. She's serious. Well, she did seem serious, but I guess that made her really serious. I finally realized that I'm in a hopeless situation.
やっと分かってくれた?よかった。これだけ言ってまだぼんやりしたこと吐かれたら、それこそどうかしてたから、私。どうかって、どんなさ?
She glares at me. I see. I guess this is what she meant by being absent-minded.
これが最後の忠告よ。そのへんてこな武器を捨てて、レイジを出しなさい。最悪腕の神経を剥がすことになるけど、命を取られるよりはいいでしょ。Screw
you. Give up my command spell? My command spell isn't something I can hand to her, and most of all...
ダメだ。それはできない。聞いておくけど、なんでよ。レイジは渡せない。それは、俺にセイバーを裏切れって言ってるのと変わらない。 そう。賛美をあげるわ。自分の命だもの、自分で選びなさい。
Tuska raises her left hand. I bet she'll release her Gondor shot the instant I refuse. Aye. Oh, hello, this is different. Well, I'm not leaving you guys hanging. I gotta make a decision right now. I wish it would word it better, like hand her the command spell or I don't want to admit defeat. We stare at each other. Did that scream come from below?
まさか、今の。
悲鳴だったわよね。
I instantly get up and start running.
ちょっと、場所はわかってるの、エミヤ君。
知るか、下からってことしかわからなかった。
ちょっと待った、今結界を解くから。
I run down the stairs.
待ってたら、一人で先走ったら危ないわよ。
You're literally just getting ready to try to kill me!
そんな場合か。さっきの姫、どう聞いても普通じゃなかったぞ。
わかってるわよ。だから危ないって言ってるんじゃない、バカ。
We get down to the first floor. There's no one moving in the hallway. But there's one collapsed female student lying there. The student is collapsed in front of the emergency exit.
よかった。気を失ってるだけか。
I check on the female student. She must be in the first year. She's unconscious, but I don't see any wounds, so she should be all right.
そんなわけないでしょ。こんなに顔は青くして、中身が空っぽだってわからない。
Was her soul taken?
中身が空っぽ。
魔力。もっと極端に言えば生命力よ。キャスターにやられた人と同じ。 いえ、あれよりもっとたちが悪い。この子、放っておいたら死ぬわ。
死ぬって、傷一つないのにか。
外が無事でも中が空っぽなら動かなくなるのは当たり前でしょ。血が全然足りないのよ。待ってて、これぐらいなら手持ちの石でなんとか。
She searches her pocket. Thank God. It seems serious, but Tuska seems to know how to cure her. Tuska kneels down and looks at the female student. Her face looks serious. She tends to the female student while sweat forms on her forehead. What's going on? That serious face of hers. I think I saw it recently.
Ah, もう気が散る。エミヤ君、そこのドア閉めてくれる？風で髪が乱れるのよ。
な、ああ。あの非常口だな。
It seems like she was trying to escape from something. I look at the open emergency exit. Open? Come to think of it, we still haven't figured out why this girl's unconscious. She didn't do this herself, so somebody else must have attacked her. We ran here right after we heard the scream, so the emergency exit is the only place to get away from. Is it because I was looking at the emergency exit? I sensed something black being shot and I protect Tuska with my right arm.
え、何よそれ。エミヤ君、腕に腐って。
Just like Tuska said, a black dagger is piercing my right arm. Yep. The thing lodged in between my wrist and my arm looks like a nail. No, it's too big to call it a nail. Something like a dagger is pierced through my arm.
なんでそんな。ああ、今はそうじゃなくて、血がそんなに出てるのに、痛くないの？
痛い。とんでもなく痛い。
But it hurts so much that I can't panic. But more than that, someone threw this at Tosca's face?
トーサカ、その子任せた。
I start running. I don't have time to wait for Tosca's response. I squeeze the strengthened metal rod out of my left hand and run out the emergency exit. I run while dangling my right arm. The arm's red below my elbow. Is there some bad luck with my arms today? Tosca told me to give her the command spell on my left arm, and now this one almost got ripped off. I look around. I don't know that what I'm feeling, but I certainly feel it. The person that attacked that female student. The person that attacked Tosca with that dagger is nearby. The person is still around. If I close my eyes, I can feel the dark magical energy moving. I jump over the hedge and run across the moldy lane. Land. Then... between the trees, someone I recognize is standing there, smiling.
Shinji?
I stop. Why is Shinji here? He's missing right now. No, Mitsuzui's the one missing. Shinji's the last one who saw her and... The injured arm throbs. The instant I fall to the ground. A nail-like dagger is thrust at my throat. I instantly dodge it. I just keep falling and keep rolling it forward to avoid it. My throat. It scraped it and my skin's cut. But this is rather fortunate. If I had been a second too late, it would have been my throat that got cut. I instantly get up. In front of me. Hey! How you doing, Ryder? Stands a woman in black with an irritating smile.
Sabato!
I'm sure of it. A concentration of magical energy even Tosca cannot stand up to. An ethereal beauty and a thick smell of blood. I don't know what class she is, but her existence is beyond human.
Kieta.
The black shadow disappears from my vision. My instincts tell me I'll be killed. I desperately swing my weapon above me. I parry the nail coming from my head. She's like a spider jumping through the woods as if she's sticking to the trees. I run. It was just pure coincidence that I was able to block that surprise attack. I can't block another attack, and there's no way I'd be able to get away. I run to a nearby tree and put my back against it. I should be able to block any attacks from behind me now. No, I have to believe that it can. I don't see that servant in black anywhere. She might be jumping from branch to branch as I don't see her coming down. Sweat rolls down my forehead. The sound of change is like that of a snake aiming for its prey. I suppress the laughter trying to escape me. The sound of chains echo through the woods. Even though I might be killed in the next moment, my mind is completely blank. I don't have any notion of time, and the guillotine isn't coming down. That's what's strange. The battle should have been over by now, but I'm still alive. It's so strange that I think I might have been killed by that previous surprise attack and might be merely dreaming now.
Seba.
I can't match a servant. Then I'll have to rely on her. The command spell. If I use the command spell to call Saber, I should be able to escape the situation. But is it all right? I placed myself in this dangerous situation. Then I should hold responsibility for that, and most of all... That's right. I have a weapon in my hand. Even if it may be a weak one. And my body can still move. If this is a bad position, I only have to move away. I can call for Saber after that. The voice echoes. She's above me, on a branch somewhere, as I expected.
And
well, I don't really know how to use it.
So, my master to chigatte yūkan nano desu ne. Anata wa.
I search around me. Where is the voice coming from?
Deva, watashi mo yarikata o kaemashou. Servanto no inai master ni honki wa dasemasen kara.
Gonna bite my neck? The voice stops. The sound of change is the only sound echoing throughout the woods. She's coming. What I have to do now is get out of this place. To do so, I would have to block her nail a few times. The fact that I have to defend myself using a chair leg is so pathetic that it's funny. If I at least had... If this stick was as splendid as the weapons he had, I might even be able to counterattack.
Ikusa!
I don't have time to think about what-ifs. It's about 30 meters to get out of the woods. This isn't much compared to the chase I had with Tosca. I run. I ignore the annoying sound of chains and run frantically towards the exit. I repel the attack from above. And then, using the weapon, I block the roundhouse kick executed by the servant. She's in front of me now. I repel her attacks.
Sonna.
The servant in black retreats. It's just a coincidence. If the first surprise attack was blocked by coincidence, these attacks were also blocked by chance. I can't even see her movements. For me to stay alive in spite of that is nothing but pure luck. But are coincidences something that can continue on like this? No. What if my assumptions are wrong in the first place? The first attack. The surprise attack to my head. Emiya Shiro could not block such attacks. I cannot block them even by coincidence.
Annette.
The servant in black murmurs. Her irritated voice is rather surprisingly beautiful. I swing at the servant in front of me. The servant in black blocks my blow and jumps back. There's nothing in my way now. The servant in black has retreated. Now all I have to do is go a few more meters and...
いいえ、そこまでです。あなたは初めから私に囚われているのですから。
My body falls. Rather, I'm being pulled back. My right arm hurts. The pierced arm is being pulled by some force?
まだわかりませんか?あなたの腕に刺さったそれは私の杭だということに。お前の杭?
That makes me realize. The thing extending from her weapon. The annoying sound of chains. The sound of the chains moving. The sound of the binding chains that I've heard since I came out of the building. I reach out for my right arm with my left, but it's too late. The arm moves up by itself and is lifted up. My arm's about to be torn off. The nail in my right arm. The chain coming out of it dangles me in the air using a branch as a fulcrum.
Sete. 先ほどは何か興味深いことを言ってらしたようですが。
The servant in black approaches. I can't run away or fight now that I'm suspended in midair.
この私が他のサーバントに劣ると。
Yeah, you probably shouldn't have said that, Shiro.
困りました。その認識を改めさせなければ、あなたを殺すのは難しい。
I'm like a sacrifice. It's like the one put to the gallows in a Western movie. The nail-like dagger is raised. The servant in black licks the tip of it.
そうですね。まずはその誤った目からいただきます。残った手足はその後に。
She jumps lightly and appears right in front of me, who's suspended 3 meters above the ground. The nail comes for me. My body still moves. Oh, come the fuck on! You're killing me, man! I mean, literally, you are quite killing me. Okay, so I could use the command spell and summon Saber, but it might be too late. By using my remaining left arm, I can pull out this nail in my right arm. One of these choices is the right one, the other two leads to death. I still have the weapon in my hand. I swing my arm while still suspended. She must have seen it coming. The servant in black avoids it midair. The death in front of me smiles. I swing my body desperately to avoid it, but it's useless. The servant mercilessly thrusts her nail at my eye. And she is shot from the side by numerous bright bullets. I fall to the ground. The bullets cut the chain and I hit my butt on the ground. The servant in black turns her back. She jumps onto a branch and retreats like a beast.
Emiya-kun, 無事?
As soon as she runs up to me, she takes my hand.
とにかく血止めしないと! Emiya-kun, 何か巻くもの持ってない?
ハンカチ発見! いつも桜が用意してくれてるんで、きっと清潔!
似た者同士か。けどないよりマシよ。 私のタオルとそれで、なんとか格好ぐらいはつけられる。
She takes my pulse and murmurs something like a spell. It must be styptic and painkiller, as my right hand feels a bit better. Tosca carefully puts the handkerchief on my wound and wraps the towel around it. Seeing her like that reminds me. Tosca is beautiful and a nice person. I was watching her from a distance, admiring her for being an honor student until 3 days ago. As it turns out, her true personality was far away from my imagination, but it's not like she was any different inside. My heart's pounding. Tosca's a nice person. She's so close to me, and she's so beautiful that I can forgive her for everything that happened up until now. I can't think. No, you're an idiot!
よし。応急処置はこんなところね。それで、あいつ何だったの? 追いついたらとんでもないことになってたから。
とにかく援護してみたけど。俺もわからない。ここまで追いかけてきて、襲われた。
I concisely tell her what happened. I decide not to say anything about seeing Shinji. It might have been my imagination, and even if it was him, I don't have any proof that he's connected with that servant.
そんな顔するな。正体はつかめなかったけど、ともかく、あいつもサーバントだろう。
Shinji must be feeding Ryder or those students.
そうね。学校に私たち以外のマスターがいるってことは知ってたけど、ようやく尻尾を出したってわけか。
Tosca slumps her shoulders. Seems Tosca already knew about this third master. Then that master is the one who attacked the female student?
また、トサカ。さっきの子はどうなった?
持ち直したわ。今は保健室で寝かせてあるから、もう大事はないと思う。そうか。それは良かった。
I sigh with relief. That means all problems have been resolved. Then what's left is...
え、何よ、人のことじっと見て。言っとくけど、私はあんなことしないからね。
I don't know how she misunderstood. Tosca? Sometimes makes the stupidest misunderstandings.
あのな、そんなの分かってる。トーサカがあんな真似するもんか。俺が言ってるのはそうじゃなくて、さっきの続きだよ。どうするんだ?やるのか、やらないのか。
Hearing this, Tosca freezes. How long did it last? Tosca glares at me once. Then hangs her head as if giving up. That's fine. But it troubles me if she makes such a face near me.
Tosca... その... どうするんだ?
やらない. 今日はここまでにする. なんだかしらけちゃったし. また借りができちゃったし.
She gets up and brushes dirt off her knees.
じゃあ行くわよ. 辛いだろうけど, 家に着くまで我慢して.
Tosca offers me her hand. Tilt my head in wonder and look at Tosca's eyes.
だから、私の家に行くわよって言ってるの。 エミヤ君、自分じゃその傷治せないんだから。
いや、それはそうだけど… なんで?
なんでも何もないわよ。 その傷、治療しないと壊死しちゃうじゃない。 それで動かなくなったりしたら、私の落ち度みたいじゃない。
Tosca pulls at me as if telling me not to talk back. Wait, I don't get it at all. Trust me, dude, neither do I, at this rate. Tosca's house is in the residential district on the other side of the town. I guess there are Western-style houses at the very top, but I've never actually been up there. This is as far as I've been, and I don't know anything about what lies ahead. So... This is the famous Western-style mansion at the top of the hill, the main base of Tosca, a magus with a prestigious lineage. I look up at the extravagant mansion, dumbfounded. Well, I thought I was used to things like this because of Shinji's house, but this has its own taste.
Emiya-kun, 玄関 こっちだけど.
I wonder what Archer's gonna do as soon as we get in there.
わかってる。わかってる。
I clear my throat and follow after Tosuka. Man, I can understand if I'm on guard being invited to another master's base, but I'm getting more nervous just thinking that I'm going into Tosuka's house.
So?
This is the living room in Tosuka's house, the place Tosuka Rin lives every day.
それじゃあ腕を見せて。
She gets straight to the point.
Oh,
I sit on a chair and show her my right arm. She takes off the towel that's wrapped around it. I think she's closer to me now. I didn't notice before, but her black hair looks really pretty and causes my heart to beat faster.
あれ?おかしいな。傷口がさっきより小さくなってる。 エミヤ君, 自然治癒のまじないでもかけてるの?
No, my body is just housing the sheath of an almighty blade. No big deal.
いや、そんなことないぞ。断じて。そうなの?その割には傷、もうほとんど塞がってるんだけど。いや、だから別に綺麗だとかなんとか。って、今、なんて言った?トウサが。だから、傷はほとんど治ってるって言ったの。私がしたのは血止めだけだから、治ってるなんてことはないはずなんだけど。
そんなこと言われても知らないぞ、俺。本当?
前にもこんなことがあったけど、本当に心当たりないの?
また、ますますわからない。前もあったって、どのくらい前のことだ?
前は前よ。エミヤ君、バーサーカーに襲われた後、背中にざっくり破片が刺さったでしょ。あの後、私が手を加えなくても傷は治ってたし。
まあ、あの時はあなた自身の魔術だと思ってたんだけど、そんな器用じゃないものね、あなた。はいはい、不器用で悪かったな。けど、それってどういうことだ?俺、今までそんなことはなかったけど。そうね。考えられるとしたら、セイバーと契約したことが原因じゃないかな。エミヤ君とセイバーがどんな契約を結んだかは知らないけど、
サーバントの中には契約者を不死にするものもいるっていうから、セイバー自身の自然治癒能力がそのままエミヤ君にも流れているのかもしれない。ふーん。なら、セイバーと契約している限りは怪我をしてもなんとかなるってことか。まあ、そういうことになるけど、それは当てにしない方がいいわよ。結局、あなたの傷を治してるのはセイバーってことになるんだから、 セイバーの魔力を消費することになるし。何より、あなたのは傷を癒す力であって、生を返すものじゃないわ。死んでしまえばそれまでなんだから、今回みたいな無茶は控えなさい。Oh.
I don't know when she did it, but the bandage is wrapped already and the treatment is done. She pats my arm and stands up.
さて、それじゃあお茶でも入れようか。 エミヤ君, 砂糖とミルクどっちがいい?
I'd prefer some milk, honestly.
いや、どっちもいらないけど... トウサカ, その前に教えてくれないか?
いいけど...
さっき言ってたことだよ。学校にもう一人マスターがいて、そいつが何かしてるって。
ああ、そのこと? そっか... エミヤ君じゃ結界には気づかないか。
I recall the female student. She was pale, and Tosuka said she would have died if we hadn't found her.
Nope.
サーバントは人の精神を食べれば食べるほど魔力を蓄えられる。学校にいるマスターはね、うちの生徒をみんな生贄にして自分のサーバントを強くしようって魂胆なんでしょ。
生徒を生贄にするって、正気かそいつ。
Well, I mean, the master is Shinji, so yeah.
さあ、けど学校にはすでに結界が張られてる。まだ完成してないけど、一度発動すれば、あの敷地にいる人間はみんな衰弱死するでしょうね。まあ、そんなことは私が許さないけど。
Tosuka explains the cool voice. This must be something she's known for days. She knew what she had to do and went to school, even though she told me not to. She knew it's dangerous to be there, but she still went to stop the master who set up the boundary field. I'm ashamed of myself. It's only natural for Tosuka to get mad at me, who came to school without thought. I wasn't prepared for anything as I was trying to continue my peaceful everyday life.
Chotto, dou shita no yo, saki kara ochikonjatte.私何か言っちゃった?
She looks at me uneasily. I bet she's misunderstanding again.
いや、そうじゃないんだ。ただ、お前には勝てないなって、そう思った。
I think it's wrong for me to apologize, so I try to tell her how I feel. Tosuka stares at me.
なんだよ。今のは、その、別にさっきのことじゃなくてだな。
わかってるわよ。それよりエミヤ君、とりあえず休戦しない?
Yes! Then... She attacks me with a smile that makes my heart jump.
休戦って、俺と遠坂で?
そう。学校に潜むマスターは立ちが悪いし、エミヤ君も敵に知られちゃったしね。私としては、あなたより先にあっちを片付けておきたいの。だからそれまで休戦して、二人でさっきのマスターを探さない?
Thank you for bringing back the Alliance! I'm taken aback, but I think calmly. No, there's no need to think. What Tosuka said is correct, and more than that, I cannot ignore this master. First of all, I decided to fight so that I can stop masters that will hurt innocent people.
No, 悪い条件じゃないと思うけど。
なあ、遠坂が力を貸してくれるなら頼もしい。
待った。別に私はエミヤ君に力を貸すわけじゃないわ。ただ、休戦協定を結んだだけよ。
そっか。敵の敵は味方。なんてわけにはいかないか。
ええ。けど、それまでは信頼して。あなたが私を裏切らない限り、私はエミヤ君を助けるから。
OK。She declares so.This is so like her, and I am honestly thankful for this fortune that's been brought upon me.
よかった。それなら、遠坂はずっと味方だ。これからよろしくな、遠坂。
I nod and hold out my right hand.
短い間だろうけど、せいぜい役に立ってよね。
Tosuka sounds ungracious, but I won't be tricked by it.Because she puts out her right hand, and most of all, because she firmly shakes my hand.
なるほどね。道理でおかしいと思った。つまりエミヤ君は正式な後継者じゃないんだ。魔術刻印を引き継ぐ前にお父さんが死んじゃったんでしょ?
どうなのかな?親父は俺に魔術刻印を引き継がせる気はなかったみたいだし、魔術師になるのには反対してた。
うん、けど、エミヤ君に魔術は教えたのよね。なんか矛盾してない?それ。
かもな。親父、俺が諦めないから仕方なく教えたって感じだったし、はじめに魔術師じゃなく魔術使いになれ、なんて言ってたし。
We talk about unimportant stuff for a while.
協力関係になった以上、エミヤ家の事情が知りたい。
Tosuka asked me that question, and it's now getting into how I learned magic. Emiya Kiritsugu was a lone wolf magus that came from the outside. In contrast, Tosuka's family has proper lineage and supervises this land. Normally, a magus from outside must show good faith to the supervisor of the land, but Kiritsugu didn't do so. Actually, he hid the fact that he was a magus. As Tosuka Rin is the head of the Tosuka family, she is the supervisor of this land even though she's young. She was entrusted with the supervision 10 years ago, and it's only recently that she's actually became able to protect the land.Well, that's why the Tosuka family never knew about Kiritsugu's existence, and why they didn't know about his son, who is a magus.
魔術使いか。 それじゃあエミヤ君、本当に素人なんだ。自分が扱える魔術以外、魔導の知識はないわけね。
ああ、そういうこと。俺が使えるのは強化だけだからな。他のことは名称とか概要とか、そんなことしかわからない。さっきだって強化で机を縦にしただけだし、あれにしたって今までで一番うまくできた魔術だった。
ちょっと本気？なんでそんなことまで私に喋るのよ、あんたは。
Because you asked. Then she gets mad like it's her own affair.
なんだ、父さか。今の突っ込むところか。
突っ込むところっていうか、あのね、エミヤ君、私たち手を組んだけど、それでも内緒にしなくちゃいけないことってあるでしょ。手の内は隠しておくべきだし、第一、魔術師にとって自分の魔術は隠し通すべきものよ。
そうか？今さら隠しても仕方がないだろう。そりゃ人には言えないことだけど、遠坂は魔術師だ。話しても問題ない。それに相手が何であれ、魔術は必死になって隠すことじゃないって親父は言ってたし。
何それ、エミヤ君の父親本気でそんなこと言ってたの？
ああ、あんまり規則にとらわれるなって言いたかったんじゃないかな、親父は。魔術なんてものは覚えない方がいいし、やめたければいつでもやめろって口癖だったぞ。
Tosca grits her teeth. What's she so irritated about? She's showing enmity to be like never before.
ふざけないで。あなたの父親は魔術師じゃないわ。そんな奴に鍛えられたあなたも魔術師なんて認めないから。
I don't know. From comments, people say that Kiritsugu was apparently a badass, but then again, that's the only thing they said, that he was a badass.
トーサカ、落ち着け。何怒ってるんだよ、お前。いや、確かにお前に比べたら俺は魔術師なんて名乗れないけど、親父は立派な魔術師だったぞ。
そうじゃない。私が言いたいのはそういうことじゃない。
Then that what? Then Tosca's enmity disappears as if she's regained her composure.
ごめんなさい。ちょっとどうかしてた。鍛え方は人それぞれだものね。私は私に胸を張ってるんだから、エミヤ君をどうこう言えるはずがなかった。
わからないな。何か気に障ったことでもあったのか？その親父の教え方とか、俺の未熟さとか。
そうね、エミヤ君の未熟っぷりには文句あるわよ。何年も魔術を鍛えていて強化しか知らないところとか、そういう弱みを私に教えちゃうところとか。
Tosca smiles suggestively. Is it just me or do I feel a chill?
そうだな、今すっごく後悔してるけど仕方ないだろ。俺には強化ぐらいしか取り柄がないし、親父は死んじまったんだから、それ以外のことを教わる方法はなかったんだ。
ええ、それが独り身の魔術師の限界ね。魔術師なんていつ死ぬかわからないんだから、そのために魔術刻印を残すんだし、教会と手を組むんじゃない。私が頭に来たのはね、そのあたりの努力を全くしなかったあなたの父親によ。魔術師の魔術はその魔術師だけのものじゃない。魔術ってのは親から子へ何代も何代も続けられてきた命の成果だもの。その責任はもう自分だけのものじゃなくなるのよ。だからそれを教わるってことは、後の世代にそれを渡すってことが第一条件になる。魔術師の家に生まれた子供は誕生した瞬間に後継者であり伝承者でもあるの。私たちはそのために生まれて、そのために死ぬ。魔術師の子供は初めから人間じゃない。うん、人として生まれたものを長い年月と厳しい修練によって別のものに変えるのが魔術師という家系の義務。
That would certainly explain your surprising lack of human emotion.
だからエミヤ君のお父さんは魔術師なんかじゃない。
あなたの父親は魔術師である前に親を取ったの。
She looks away as she says so. I don't know why Tosca's mad. What Tosca thought when she was raised in this house. How much she sacrificed to train as the daughter of a family of magi. I can't put myself in her place no matter how hard I try.
なあ、トサカ。もしかしてそれで俺を目の敵にしてたのか。魔術師としての心構えがなってないから。
そうよ。あなたのことは嫌いじゃないけど。魔術師としては認められないもの。だからそのつい急を据えるっていうかつっつきたくなったの。悪い？
あ、いや悪いけど忠告は助かった。今日のことがなかったら学校のマスターにも気づかなかったし、東坂とも手を組めなかった。
I stare at her for affirmationTosca ponders for a bit.
もう、なんだってこんなのがセイバーのマスターなのよ。
She complains about something strange. We've been talking so long, it's already gotten dark. It's almost 7 o'clock. Saber will get mad if I don't go home soon.
じゃあ、トサカ、マスター探しは学校でするんだな。
ええ。明日の放課後、廊下で待ち合わせましょう。ああ。それと帰りはアーチャーをつけてあげる。私はやることがあるから送ってあげられないけど、アーチャーがいれば問題ないでしょ。
Oh, this ought to be good. I realize I've been forgetting about it all along. This is Tosca's house, so it's not strange for Archer to be here. Hey, dude! The knight in red, Archer, takes form. Come to think of it, this is the first time I've actually faced him. The man that almost got his head cut off by Saber that night.The man that tried to shoot Saber along with Berserker. Is it because of such things? I face him and instinctively feel that I hate him. I probably will never be able to accept him. It must be the same for Archer as he stares at me with enmity. I appreciate that. If he hates me, I can hate him back without holding back.
よろしくね、アーチャー。彼とは協力関係になったから、襲いかかったりしちゃダメよ。
わかっている。マスターの指示には従うさ。
Archer disappears. Since he can't go out there dressed like he is, it must mean he will guard me in spirit form. I walk through the night town. It's still 7 o'clock, so I still see people around. I don't think any guard is necessary, but I can't turn down her goodwill. But maybe I should have refused.My nerves are getting strained. There are goosebumps on my skin, and I might throw up if I let my guard down. I feel hostility from behind me. The invisible guard is watching out for the one he has to protect. Man, how is he a guard? The hostility I feel is definitely coming from the man behind me.
この辺りでいい。あんまり近づくと、前みたいなことになりかねない。
I tell the presence behind me. Archer doesn't answer. He just accepts my words and tries to leave.
待てよ。なんか言いたいことがあるんじゃないのか、お前。
I glare at the invisible guy. The leaving presence stops. He appears with hostility still present.
見直したよ。殺気を感じ取れる程度には心得があるらしい。いや。てっきり虫も殺さない平和主義者だと思っていたが。
I keep getting called a pacifist lately. Kind of the. Okay, I have no problem with being a pacifist, but it's kind of a different alt. It's a kind of different whenever they're trying to call you insultingly like a pacifist, you know?
バカにすんな。これでも魔術師だぞ、俺は。相手がやる気だって言うんなら、いくらでも相手になる。
I confront the knight in red.He smiles as if to make fun of me and shrugs his shoulders.
たわけたこと。血の匂いがしない魔術師など半人前だ。死にそう教わらなかったのか、エミヤシロ。
How would you know, Kiritsugu? My spirits weaken. Kiritsugu certainly said so. Magi are tinged with blood. It doesn't matter if you hurt or don't hurt anyone. This path is a path wet with blood. That's why Kiritsugu told me not to be a
Magus.
その点においても、エミやシロはマスターには向いていない。リンとは大違いだな。
なんだそれ。遠坂は血の匂いがするっていうのか。
するとも。あれはいささか甘すぎる嫌いはあるが、それでも手を下すときは容赦すまい。そうでなくては、連日マスターを探して町を巡回などしないさ。
She's looking for other masters every day? That means she's fighting other masters. It's not like it's over once she finds a master. Then...
じゃあ、遠坂は今日みたいなことを毎日してるのか?
The event at school. The same thing that happened in the woods today.
まさか。今日のような手たらくは、今回限りにしてほしいものだ。あれだけの意志と能力を持った魔術師が、お前を相手にするとどうも年相応に戻ってしまう。大体彼女の能力ならエミやシロと協力する必要などないのだ。にもかかわらず余分なことをしている。私としては協力など反対なのだが、まあ仕方があるまい。サーヴァントはマスターに従うものだ。そうだろ、エミやシロ。たとえマスターが役に立たない未熟者でも、サーヴァントは従わなければならないということだ。
Is he talking about me and Saber?
そうかよ。遠坂も気の毒だな。お前みたいなひねくれ者と組まされてな。
まったく、呆れる。まだそんなことを口にするのか。忠告するが、サーヴァントの性格など考慮するな。我らはただ戦うために呼び出された者。所詮サーヴァントはレイジュでつながれた道具に過ぎない。支配権はお前たちにあるのだから、道具のざれ言など聞き流す。
You would probably hate me immensely if I was the one that summoned you and I started treating you like a human.I can't tell him that's not the case. What Archer, the one bound by the command spell, said is definitely true. I can't think of Saber as a tool, but it's true that Saber is bound by the command spell.
で、呼び止めた要件は何だ?まさか親睦を深めようなどと、ふざけた理由ではあるまい。
Well, if it was me personally, even if you would hate it, I would at least try to make friends with you. Ugh, I don't have a reason.I just didn't like him, so I wanted to complain to him.
その、そうだ、アーチャー、お前も聖杯が欲しいのか?
I ask an obvious question in desperation. Then?
聖杯? はあ、人間の望みを叶えるという悪質な宝箱か。興味はないな。私の望みは、そんなものでは叶えられまい。
The evil treasure chest. So, the way he phrased that, would he. Does that imply that this archer knows what the real Holy Grail is? The Knight in Red declares contemptuously. That's contradictory. Servants desire the Holy Grail. Isn't that why they answer the call of the Magus and become servants?
Wait, おかしいぞ、お前。なら、なんでサーヴァントになんてなってんだよ。
成り行き上、仕方なくだ。私に自由意志などない。お前はサーヴァントが自らの意志で呼び出しに応じているとでも思っているのだろうがな。
Don't have free will. Does that mean he was called against his will even though he doesn't want the Holy Grail?
幸せな男だ。本当に考えたことはなかったのか?いいか。サーヴァントとは呼び出されるものだ。いいな。英霊とは全て自らの意思ではなく他者の意思によって呼び出される。過去の功績によって英霊となり 以後は人々の間で語り継がれ、その支えになるもの。だが、その塔の英霊自身が心の底から人間の助けになりたいなどと思っていると。
In all honesty, probably not. I don't know. If they are called heroic spirits, they should be pure. That's why I imagine them protecting people, but that's not the case for a lot of the servants I've encountered.
そうだ。もともと英霊というものに意志などない。英霊となったものは以後ただ人間を守る力として置かれるだけだ。何かこちらで不都合があった場合のみ呼び出され、その後始末をして消えるだけの存在。あるがないもの。人の世の危機を救おうが誰にも認識されないもの。それが英霊。守護者と呼ばれる都合のいい存在だ。なってしまったが最後、意志を剥奪され、永遠に人間のために働き続ける掃除屋に過ぎん。
One that is summoned only to disappear. Heroic spirits are tools without a will?
そんなはずはない。セイバーもお前もちゃんと意志があるじゃないか。そりゃ、自分の意志とは無関係に呼び出されたかもしれないけど、それでも、こっちに出てきてからの選択肢はあるんじゃないのか。セイバーだって、やりたくないことはやらないって突っぱねるし。
当然だろう。我々はサーバントだ。誰が作ったシステムだか知らんが、この戦いはよくできている。
If all honesty, in all honesty, if I knew who caused the system, I'd like to give them a nice hearty punch to the face.
本来、本体からの触覚でしかない英霊に形を与え、本体そのものとして刺激するのだからな。サーバントという殻を与えられた英霊は、その時点で元の人間性を取り戻せる。故に、サーバントは聖杯を求めるのだろうよ。聖杯を得れば、叶わなかった無念を晴らせるだろうし、短い時間であれ、人間として、この世界にとどまれるのだから。
人間としてとどまれる。
This must mean that they can be set free as an individual and not a servant. And to add, the Holy Grail has powers to grant wishes. If it allows them to grant the wishes they had before they died, it's natural for servants to cooperate with their masters. So the Holy Grail must be a miracle for the servants as well.
なんで、そこまでのものを、なんでお前はいらないって言うんだ。叶えられなかった願いを叶えられるし、サーバントでなくなることだってできるっていうのに。
単純な話だ。私には叶えられない願いなどなかった。他の連中とは違う。私は望みを叶えて死に、英霊となった。故に、叶えたい望みなどないし、人としてここに留まることにも興味はない。それは、お前のサーバントも同じだろうさ。
バカ言うな。セイバーは聖杯が必要だって言ったんだ。お前みたいに目的がなくてサーバントをやってるわけじゃない。
私のも。
Archer murmurs. Why is it? It's just a normal murmur, but a chill runs through me.
目的があろうとなかろうと同じだ。気になるのならば問いただしてみるがいい。セイバーの目的は聖杯でありながら、決して聖杯を自分のためには使わない。そういった意味で、あれは典型的な守護者。文字通り、奴隷なのだ。そのことを、彼女のマスターであるのなら、決して忘れないことだ。
His presence disappears. The knight in red talks cynically until the very end and leaves.
ただいま。
And that's where I'm gonna end it. Hmm. Well. Well, the good news is the Alliance is back. Not sure how it's gonna work. I'm not entirely sure how it's going to work out this time, though. Hmm. So it seems like this time we're cooperating to take care of Shinji. Or, I'm sorry, Ryder. You know! Hmm. I wonder if we'll learn Ryder's real identity, though. Hmm. It seems like Castor's playing a more influential role this time. So we might learn more about her, too. Hmm. Oh shit, this almost went on for about 2 hours. Shit. Well, hope you guys like a double dose of this. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next video. I literally got nothing at the moment.